Currently, the majority of cancer research performed in the lab is performed on a two-dimensional surface, like plastic or glass, and this doesn't replicate human biology because humans are not two-dimensional. We are designing ways in that we can study cancer in three dimensions using different materials. Specifically, we use a jelly-like substance, and using this substance, we can put cancer cells inside and we can watch them grow and we can watch them interact with each other as we design these tissues in the lab. What we can also do is use these models as a way to more specifically screen for drugs to make drug treatments more accurate and more personable. When drugs are tested two-dimensionally, 95% of those drugs that are positive in that instance will fail once they reach the clinic. And what we need to know is when those drugs are applied, how do those tumour cells interact with their surrounding environment? Which you don't get with that 2D. We're eliminating that whole tissue environment from its surroundings and we're not getting realistic results. So we want to be able to use these mini tissues to work out the drug that's going to work best for that patient. In that way, so they spend less time in the hospital and more time at home with their families. In the future, we would hope that these 3D models offer us information about a patient's cancer. We would hope that it would offer us information about how aggressive this patient's cancer is going to be. Is it going to move around the body? And if so, what treatment would be best to use for this patient? There have been decades of cancer research performed up until this point, and I'm entirely grateful to those cancer researchers that have dedicated their lives to this cause. And I really feel like we're now taking the next step. So this next generation of cancer research is going to be the most exciting, and it's going to give us the most results that we've been looking for years.